In our lab, we focus on developing new energy-efficient processes to remove nutrients from wastewater. So part of this mission involves reducing the amount of oxygen that is usually required to remove nitrogen, carbon, and phosphorus from wastewater. Nitrogen is usually removed through a process called nitrification. So conventionally, nitrification has been considered a two-step reaction, where first, ammonia-oxidizing bacteria and archaea oxidizes ammonia to nitrite, and then other organisms, nitrite-oxidizing bacteria, or NOBs, oxidize nitrite to nitrate. However, in 2015, two research groups, one in the Netherlands and another one in Austria, discovered a new type of microorganism that was capable of oxidizing ammonia all the way to nitrate. After the discovery of comammox, people started to realize that comammox has been present in different environments, but people didn't know before about this microorganism. We operate the reactor under different operational stages. We change the conditions of the reactor. And since back in 2014, we had no idea about comammox, we couldn't realize if we, at that specific point, we had that microorganism present in the reactor. But we saved DNA samples from that reactor, and we recently sequenced them. And by sequencing them and analyzing the data from the sequencing, we realized that we had comammox present at that specific time point of the reactor operation. We identify specific traits associated with energy metabolism that differentiate comammox from NOB like Nitrospira. For example, only comammox-like genomes harbor gene clusters responsible for oxidation of ammonia to nitrite. As expected, both comammox and NOB-like genomes encoded genes responsible for the second step of nitrification. All comammox-like genomes encoded the machinery to hydrolyze urea. This urolytic activity is only present in the genome of some NOB-like Nitrospira. Only NOB-like genomes had the capability to convert cyanate into ammonia, since they encode a cyanase hydratase enzyme. All the comammox genomes contain a sulfur-reducing hydrogenase gene set, which could give this subgroup an advantage when growing under anaerobic conditions. One of the features of comammox is that it has been found mainly in low oxygen conditions. Since we studied different microorganisms, we realized that there are other ammonia-oxidizing bacteria and nitrite-oxidizing bacteria that can also survive under low oxygen conditions, so comammox is not the only one. But it's good for us to understand, depending on the process that we want to carry out in a wastewater treatment plant, which microorganisms we need to favor and the conditions that will favor the growth of these specific microorganisms.